Hello everyone. I'm doing a review on my first purchase on Bring a Trailer. I was looking for a third gen Camaro, yellow Iroc. I kind of keep my eye on those because I had a couple of them when I was younger, over 20 years ago. And this one popped up. Looked like a really nice example. 50,000 miles, 85, first year Iroc. The thing that was kind of big for me was it was for sale by Curious Cars. If you know Bill on YouTube, really does some good reviews, pretty funny guy. So figured for my first purchase, it would be nice to, I guess, buy it from a car enthusiast, somebody who's known in the community. And I felt confident with making the deal because this car is in Florida. I'm in Arizona. I'm not going to see it in person. And yeah, it's, you know, by the pictures and his video review, because he did put a video review on YouTube, which you can check out yourself there. And, you know, it has a nice Carfax report. Lots of pictures. I think it had over 200 pictures on it. You know, it was described pretty well, outside of some stuff that I noticed when I got it that I wasn't too thrilled about, and we will review that and I'll point it out to you. Says the lower portion of the front bumper cover is said to have been refinished and paint chips are present in the driver's mirror. That kind of is the only thing that it really says, and that the thermostat is slow working. Well, there's a crack in the passenger door panel. And it says the coolant temperature is said to function slowly. Trip odometer does not work. You know, just little stuff. I mean, it's nearly a 40-year-old car. But what we'll do is we'll do a little walk around of the car, take it for a little test drive, see if there is any discrepancies from the listing, kind of tell you a little bit about how the transaction went overall, you know, the process of sending the money, shipping, stuff like that. Just in case you're looking to purchase your first vehicle, you can see sold on November 21st. Today is the 6th. I got the car about 3 days ago. Haven't really driven it very far, and just want to kind of go through the car and check it over. So stay tuned. Wednesday morning, and we're gonna go take this for a little ride. Not really driven this car, kind of just rolled it off the trailer that was delivered on a couple days ago. Did have my detailers come over and do a mobile detail, and they, you know, gave it a good little wash and stuff like that. Went and titled, registered it. It was quite the little process to get the car here from Florida. Bill was awesome with helping get it shipped over. The cost was $1,300. That was in an enclosed trailer. You know, that process on Bring a Trailer, you know, I was just never done it before. I've watched a lot of cars in there. I even bid on some cars. But finally to win my first one, I was pretty thrilled about it. You know, it was a lot of fun.
Don't mind any of the rattles. Road's a little rough here. And, well, it's a 80s Camaro. 80s GM product. So you gotta love that. I'm not gonna drive this car very far. I don't know the car that well. I just don't have any trust in it yet. All of the gauges look like they're working pretty good. Oil pressure looks where it should be at. Battery gauge. We'll get some gas in it because you can't always trust these gauges. And last thing I want to do is be pushing this big beast. Looks like the temp gauge is going up pretty slowly. Yeah, blinker works. We'll kind of go through this car and make sure that everything is working and as described. One thing I did notice was the rear view mirror. You can see it's kind of got some little issues in it. Nothing too crazy. But yeah, this brings back memories. Last yellow Iroc I had was over 20 years ago. My son was about 2 years old, and he's 22 years old now. He is more excited than I am about this car, and he can't wait to drive it, you know, and it's pretty cool to be able to, you know, share the love of this car with him, because, I mean, it was my car when I was younger, actually when I was his age. I'm going to try to find a parking lot to park in that doesn't have a lot of traffic, a little quiet, and maybe I can do this review. Nice guy. All right, cowboy. I mean, he had to have seen me. I mean, I'm in a bright yellow Iroc-Z. People are wild these days, you know? People are wild. Seems like it's driving pretty good. Pulls a little bit to the left. I'll check the tire pressures. That's usually the cause of stuff like that. We're out here in Arizona, so the temperature's pretty nice. It is supposedly winter time. Never feels like it. Never feels like Christmas out here either. Brakes feel pretty good. Does have four-wheel disc brakes. Shifts pretty firmly. Actually, really firmly. A lot of these transmissions were slush boxes. The 700R4 transmissions. They weren't known for being the best transmissions out there. Find a place to pull over, and we'll do the walk around and go through the car and see how it is. Stay tuned. All right, guys, I apologize in advance for any background noise, but I wanted to find a little shady spot behind this building just to kind of give you a little walkthrough of the vehicle. And by all purposes, it looks pretty good. You know, just like in Bill's video, it does look good. I did notice a few things that weren't so good. If you look here at the paint, we have touch-up paint here. And then here, and here, and here. That was just some spots here on the front. There's some in this area right here. I'll pop the hood and show you some more of that. These paint chips were noted in the listing. Surprised they didn't touch those up too. A lot of touch up paint back here on the spoiler. I mean, you can kind of see along here. You know, a fair amount of touch up paint used. And I just think stuff like that should be listed. Obviously, you guys saw the cold start video, smoke on startup. That was not in the listing. What else is there to look at here? I mean, overall, the condition of the vehicle is really good. Good tires, some BF Goodrich G-Force Comp 2s. Wheels were refinished. It is not the same gold color from the factory. It's a little darker. Still looks pretty good. I don't mind it. I'm not hating it. So look in the interior. That crack was listed. That radio right here is period correct, but it is not the original. The original is right here in the back seat. Because when they came with this clock here, they didn't have a clock on the radio, I believe. It was just a tuner. But it's cool to have, nonetheless. Came with this. I haven't went through it yet, but looks like it's a book of receipts. Awesome. Let's open up this. Got an extra set of keys. The original owner's manual. Doesn't have the original floor mats, has these rubber ones. I'll find some tan original floor mats with the nice little GM logo on it. Interior's in really nice shape. Especially for being tan. Usually these tans take a beating. You know, your side bolster's in good shape. Yeah, it's overall very nice condition. 1985, 50,000 miles. You know, let's just go through some of the features, see what's working. I want to kind of check the radio here. Power button. All right, baby. Pretty good. All right. Let's see if that power antenna did come up. And it works. Awesome. Want to check our lights here. Looks like the electric fan is working pretty good. You can hear it. Lights. Put the fog lights on. Lights work. Ooh. Ooh, got one fog light out. All the lights are on. Power windows work good. As you can see, I have them down. Check blinkers. Ooh. And your side and your front. Check the other side here real quick. I just like to do stuff like this, you know, check everything out. I did fill it up with gas on the way here. Got a nice full tank in it. I did notice one other thing, and it was that the temp gauge now is reading at zero. So something to look at. The electric fan is working, so that makes me feel a lot better. But let's start her up. Yeah, see that temp gauge is kind of not working right. I'm gonna probably change out that temp sensor. It's like a sender unit. I think it's up top. It's pretty easy to access, cheap part. Everything else looks good. Fuel gauge works. So yeah, I mean the clock in it works. I need to test it. Looks like the second hand is kind of it's broken off in there. But still cool. You don't see these with the clock very often. I'm just trying to, you know, I'm just looking over the car, seeing what else there could be. Let's pop the hood on it. All right. Well, it looks pretty nice under here. I did get a whiff of fresh paint. And I believe that there was some stuff down here underneath. If you look at this, a lot of times it's because, you know, you get little surface rust like this on these cars. They're very known for it. You know, people wash them, the seals. You might see a little bit here. Nothing crazy. Pretty actually normal for these cars. But I think this was all, it feels just like it was painted like reasonably recently. Don't know why. Maybe it was just to cover up some surface rust that was in this area. But yeah, overall, we'll have to change that temp sensor that's on it. Pretty sure, where is it on here? But it's fairly easy to get to. I see a little oil there. You know, and I'm being critical, obviously, because I paid $20,000 for this, $20,250. And, you know, you just want to make sure that you got your money's worth. I still feel I got a good deal. Hey, it's got an AC Delco battery, not a Walmart special. Nothing wrong with Walmart batteries. I buy them all the time. I don't see anything leaking under there. You know, and I had a lot of pictures. I had over 200 pictures of it. Yeah. Overall, I'm still pretty happy with this car, regardless of the undisclosed touch-up paint and the smoke on startup. Maybe I could try some of that AT205 stop leak and see if it helps and engine restore. And see if it gets rid of the smoke on startup. If not, it's going to be valve seals, probably, I'm guessing, $1,000 or less at a shop. But if you were to do it yourself, it'd probably be $50 in parts. So what do you guys think about this car? Put it down in the comments. Do you think I got a good deal? What do you think about the stuff that wasn't disclosed in the listing? I mean, you take your chances on those auctions. But I felt pretty confident buying from Bill. And I'm not mad at Bill. I still love Bill. I'll still watch his videos. You know, it's a little bit of touch-up paint. Smoke on startup. But overall, I think I got a good deal. I did purchase a 91 Z28 1LE car. And that will be arriving in a week or so. Probably a week and a half. And I'm going to do a review on that car. I bought it on Bring It the Trailer. I got a good deal on it. $14,444. You know, you add all the shipping, Bring It trailer fees, and you're at, you know, well, I'm probably going to be around $17,000 on that car. This car, Bring It trailer fees, shipping. I am into this car for 22 and a half, I believe. Yeah, 22 and a half. So yeah, I appreciate you guys stopping by. Check out some more reviews that are coming up on purchases, other cars, stuff like that. And I'll see you next time. Comment down below, let me know what you think about my purchase. Have a good one.